Good afternoon. Welcome as we celebrate the first Sunday of Advent. It is also Food Pantry Sunday. We have an additional collection for our food pantry, and those baskets are further back on the altar platform. In the month of November, there were 787 household visits. Groceries were driven home to 432 households. As you can imagine, this tremendous increase in service and need, we also need more volunteers. So Jeff is right over there. So if the Holy Spirit touches you, taps you on the shoulder during Mass, please go over and talk with him. It doesn't have to be a death sentence, lifetime commitment. It could just be one day, a couple times a month, but just your help is very much needed. And also, we are continuing to receive donations for our Giving Tree. Gift cards of $35 are given to for each child in a family, 12 and under, and so that is what this money is being collected for, children who are guests, their families are guests of our food pantry. And finally, Father O'Brien calls us putting a front porch on it. Our condolences to the St. Rose community and the devastating news that we've received, I'm an alumna, this week, and we are praying for all of you, all of us.
Please stand as we sing number 338 in your green gather hymnal under your chairs.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, as we gather on this first Sunday of Advent, let us ask forgiveness with confidence, for our God is full of gentleness and compassion. You came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for all your people.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on all of us, forgive us our sin, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Rend the heavens and come down, O God of all the ages. Rouse us from sleep, deliver us from our heedless ways, and form us into a watchful people, that at the advent of your Son, he may find us doing what is right, mindful of all you command. Grant this through him whose coming is certain, whose day draws near, your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father. Our Redeemer, you are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribe of your heritage. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you, while you wrought awesome deeds we could not hope for, such as they had not heard of from of old. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay and you the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Be saved.
Lord, may
Israel, hearken from your throne and shine forth. Arouse your power and come to save us.
Lord, make us turn to you. Show us your face, and we shall be saved.
We are your chosen vine. Only by your care do we live. Reach out your hand, O Lord, unto your people.
Lord, make us turn to you. Show us your face, and we shall be saved.
If you will dwell with us, we shall live anew in your love. Oh, shine upon us, great Lord of life.
Lord, make us turn to you. Show us your face, and we shall be
a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Jesus Christ, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift, as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you were called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, we have a reading from the Holy Gospel as recorded for us by Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all. Wake up." The Gospel of the Lord. Advent offers us an opportunity to begin again. To begin again our following in the footsteps of Jesus the Christ. And if ever there was a need for us to begin again, certainly it's now. We who live in a divided world, a divided nation, a divided church. The longer I live and serve the church, I find myself thinking about and praying for our church to imitate civil administrations. And yes, there are always voices ready to remind me that the church is not a democracy. And my response is, why not? I remember early on when I was first ordained, an older priest mentioned to me that the church, through the centuries, always adopted the ways of the society in which it found itself. We've been too passive too long, not inviting married people, women, to serve in positions of leadership in our church. And it cries out, as Isaiah does, to heaven for redress. Tonight, Isaiah admits his people's sinfulness, but is at the same time quick to recall God's mercy. And the opening prayer echoes Isaiah's plea that God would tear open the heavens and come down, that the nations might tremble at God's presence. Advent is a time to open our hearts and invite the Lord to bring us to completion. In our Advent yearning for his coming, Isaiah employs more imagery. We have all withered like leaves, blown like the wind. And Isaiah proposes the dead leaves as symbols of all that is dried up and withered in our lives. He calls us to look for a better day. And Mark's gospel is brief and to the point. Beware. Keep alert. Keep awake. The master is going on a journey, but beforehand he leaves his servants in charge, each with their own work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on watch. In 2023, it might read like this: what I say to you, not just to the bishops, not just to the priests, not just to the deacons, not just to the males, but to all, keep awake. The warning is for all of Jesus' followers of all times. 20-plus centuries have gone by since he issued that challenge. So we ask ourselves, what has happened to this command of Jesus? How do we go about it today? Is it a vibrant faith that we have, or is it dying out through indifference and mediocrity? Do we see that the church needs a new heart? We need to fall again, to fall in love again with Christ. Have we let the institution get in the way of that need? The institution gives us 4 weeks to do just that. Will we use the time to our advantage? The servant of God, Dorothy Day, wrote more than 60 years ago, "We must cry out against injustice, or by our silence, consent to it. If we keep silent, the very stones of the street will cry out." I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us confidently place our needs before the Lord and each other and our petitions.
For the Church, as we await the birth of the Prince of Peace, may our voices and actions ring out to seek peace for all God's people, we pray.
Lord.
For all those who hold power in our world, as countless refugees await the opportunity for a safe home, May the eyes and hearts of all leaders be open to act and ease their suffering. We pray. For those in our community who are homeless, as the cold of winter approaches, may they find warmth and loving care. We pray. For our St. Vincent's parishioners and others newly confirmed in the Catholic faith, as they enter a new life in Jesus, may the Holy Spirit fill them with grace. We pray. For the children blessed by our parish support of the Giving Tree, may their comfort and joy be abundant this Christmas season. We pray. For the students, faculty, staff, and alumni of the College of St. Rose, in this time of devastating upheaval and loss, may they receive comfort in their sorrow and the resources to move forward. We pray. For Reverend Michael Fufford, Maury Vrooman, Joseph Young Ki Kim, Anna G. Soon Kim, and all those who have died before us, gone before us in faith, may they rest in the embrace of the loving God. We pray. For the concerns expressed in our Book of Intentions and those we hold in our hearts, we pray.
Good and gracious God, hear the prayers we place before you with great confidence, and give us that which we have not had the wisdom nor the insight to ask for, but which you see as being necessary if we are to be an Advent people. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
The prayer for the...
Oh, I'm sorry. Lord our God, we praise you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He is Emmanuel, the hope of the peoples. He is the wisdom that teaches and guides us. He is the Savior of every nation. Lord God, let your blessing come upon us as we light the first candle of this wreath. May the wreath and its light be a sign of Christ's promise to bring us salvation. May he come quickly and not delay. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. I invite you now, if you brought an offering, to place it in the baskets at the base of the altar platform. If you prefer to give online, you may do so by going to our website and clicking the donate button.
Oh,
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our offerings be pleasing and acceptable to the Creator in heaven. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hand
for the praise and glory of God's name,
for our good and all the rest of the church.
Accept, Lord, our offerings chosen from among your many gifts, and let this present expression of our reverence become for us the pledge of eternal redemption. And we ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Holy God, almighty and eternal one, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. When first he came among us in the lowliness of human flesh, he fulfilled the plan you formed long ago and opened for us the way to salvation. Now, hoping that the salvation promised us will be ours, we watch for the day when Christ will come again in majesty and glory. And so with angels and archangels, with all the heavenly host, we proclaim your glory and join their unending chorus of praise.
Holy.
From the beginning, O God, all you have done for the human family, you have done for our good, that we may be holy as you yourself are holy. Look with kindness then on your people gathered before you. Send forth your spirit and power that these gifts may become for us the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, in whom we too are your children. When we were lost and our hearts were far from you, you showed the depth of your love. Your Son, who alone is the just one, gave himself into our hands and was nailed to the wood of the cross. Before he stretched out his arms between heaven and earth as the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover in the company of his disciples. While they were at table, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." At the end of the meal, knowing that he would reconcile all things in himself by his blood poured out on the cross, he took the cup filled with wine. Again, he gave you thanks. And handing the cup to his friends, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord.
We remember Jesus Christ, our Passover and our lasting peace. We celebrate his death and resurrection. We await the blessed day of his return. And so we present to you, God, ever faithful and true, the offering that restores the world to your grace. Merciful God, look with love on those who draw to yourself through their sharing in the sacrifice of Christ. By the power of your Spirit, may they become the body of your risen Son, in whom all divisions are healed. Keep us in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, the Bishop of Rome, Edward, the Bishop of Albany, and with ministering peoples everywhere. Help us to work for the coming of your kingdom, until at last we stand in your presence and take our place among the saints, with Mary and the apostles, our departed sisters and brothers, and all whom we commend to your mercy. Then in the glory of your new creation, freed from the sting of death, we shall sing to you the hymn of thanksgiving, which rises from Christ, the living Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Taught by our Savior's command and formed by the word of God, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, we beg you, Lord, from all evils, and grant us peace in our times. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Our Lord Jesus Christ, you promised us peace before leaving us. We ask you, Lord, to look not on our faults, our human failings, but rather that you would look on our faith, and that one day you would gather us all around your table, where you live and reign today and forever. And may the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with us always. Let us bless each other with the sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Sisters and brothers, this is the bread of life and the cup of blessing. This is the Lamb of God who comes to take away our sin. Happy are we who are called tonight to be guests at this table. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed, the body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, you have nourished us with the food of life. Through our partaking of this sacrament, teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and to cherish those of heaven. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The art retreat that was scheduled for this past Friday, December 1st, has been postponed to next Friday, December 8th, and the time is from 9 to 2, I believe, but check the bulletin for that to be sure. And our trivia contest and potluck supper that was supposed to take place this evening has been postponed to January 6th. Again, it will be following immediately after this Mass. Mass will be offered on the Vigil of the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception at 6 o'clock on Thursday, December 7th, this week. This feast commemorates the dogma that Mary was born, was without sin from the beginning of her life. And liturgical ministers are encouraged to volunteer to assist with that liturgy. The program Aligning Money with Your Values, it will be offered next Sunday, December 10th at 9:45 a.m. Local musicians and readers will offer an Advent evening of reflection on December 15th at 7 p.m. here in church. Junior choir is forming to sing at the 4 p.m. Mass on Christmas Eve. They will be rehearsing after the 11 o'clock Mass next Sunday, the 10th, and the following Sunday, the 17th. Inspirational stories, songs, and prayers for hope will be offered December 3rd from 3 to 5 p.m. in the Interfaith Sanctuary at the College of St. Rose. There will be a reconciliation service for children and families December 9th at 3 o'clock, and additional services December 13th at Blessed Sacrament at 7 o'clock and St. Vincent's on December 18th, also at 7 o'clock. The monthly newsletter, The Snapshot, was sent out to everyone for whom we have an email address this week, so if you didn't get it, please call the office so that you can be put on that list if you would like to receive it. And also, the photos that were left on the windowsills for the Month of All Souls, any that were left behind are in the Blessed Sacrament Chapel if you had not picked up your family member's photo. Are there any birthdays, anniversaries, or other significant events to note? Well, enjoy a blessed week.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Lord look upon us and be gracious to us, and as we go forward, allow us to be a blessing to each other and to all those we meet. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
We have celebrated Eucharist. Let us continue our good service of the Lord and all of the Lord's people.
Thanks be to God.